Tonight's snow showers are winding down as we have the weather system responsible for them starting to move out of our hair. We should have all these showers done by midnight as that area of low pressure moves on. Even though we have a bit of a cold front moving in, and the air behind that is still very mild, so we'll continue our warming trend over the rest of the week once this weather system fully moves on by. Zooming in on satellite and radar, still seeing some light flurry activity for some spots. And from Freeport towards Clinton, we are getting an additional line of light snow showers. This should be the last one moving through. That'll slide by over the next hour. By the time we get to midnight, all spots in the state line will be drying on out. In general, accumulations have been at or under a half an inch of snow with not much else coming. However, we still are seeing the snow stick to the roads despite these light amounts, so drive with caution into tomorrow morning as a result of that snow sticking around to those roads. So even very light amounts can cause some slick conditions. We don't need inches of snowfall to cause some slippery roads. You can see on our downtown camera that we do have snow covered conditions in some spots of State Street downtown. So also we're hearing reports of, from various viewers on our Facebook Live earlier this evening saying that they saw slick roads around their neighborhood. So drive a little caution going into those early morning hours. 25 degrees currently, a lot warmer than the past couple days, even though we're still well below average for this time of year. Some of the winds will cause temperatures to not drop off much tomorrow. That sets us up for a chance to get back into the 30s for the first time in a while. Wind chill down to 19, only expecting to see wind chills in the teens overnight. Should only drop down to about 21 under a cloudy sky as the weather continues to dry on up. And then temperatures will rise a little further tomorrow, back to 30 degrees with some cloud cover early, then some afternoon sunshine on that 30 degree point. Not quite above freezing yet, but it's the first time since 1 a.m. on Monday that we'll be back into the 30s. So it's been a long stretch since temperatures have at least managed to get back up into the 30s. Again, could see that streak end by Thursday. And by Friday, expected to see above freezing temperatures for the first time since this hour early Monday morning. So it'll be nice to get at least freeze to be ending quite soon here. You can see in general on this trend that temperatures will be near to above freezing for Friday. We'll continue that warming trend into the weekend, close to 40 degrees over the course of the weekend, even with a lot of cloud cover overhead. And as you look towards Sunday, there is a chance for some light rain and snow as part of that next little warm-up that gets us into the 40s by early next week. Here we are towards the middle of Sunday morning and seeing some light drizzly conditions across the state line. You can see off to the north there are some signs of a rain-snow mix, so may see some flurries early Sunday. A little accumulation there and little accumulation for the rain as well as we advance future track into Sunday afternoon. Note that the rain looks very light on future track radar and we'll continue to have that into Sunday evening. So plan on drizzly conditions with some flurries in the morning. Not much for accumulation going into Sunday itself, and we'll keep you up to speed if we do see any hints of iciness towards the end of the weekend. Going into next week, we're dry, temperatures back to the 40s. This would still be below average for this time of year, but we do have us trending closer to that, and we should hold on to those above freezing temperatures for a while next week. James and Kristen.
Good. I'm looking forward to finally seeing November. Thanks, Alex. Still